You were very active 2 years ago in MPS and the Opportunity Schools. You've obviously been spending a lot of time on transportation and income tax reform.
Yep.
But do you envision another reform plan for MPS? Because you and I know the four-year graduation rate at MPS is still about 55%.
I think the word reform is thrown around loosely.
Okay.
I don't know how...
Major pilot opportunities or something?
Yeah, no, I think, I mean, they'll definitely be doing stuff for MPS. It's very close to my heart. It's close to Senator Darling's heart. I think that is the first step of economic development and wholesome families and a great community. And the stats you just mentioned are just jaw-dropping and don't serve anyone except the status quo. You know, the governor put a lot of money in education, largest increase ever. What we'd like to see is some of that money maybe dedicated to third-party organizations like a Reading Corps that has been very successful in other states to increase the amount of proficiency of reading using exact science and volunteers. Also, there's a place called College Possible that's been very successful in connecting high school students with college options. Taking that money and trying to see if we can do something with organizations that have a lot of people on there that have business mindsets and know what's working and have a heart for change, and see if we could have those folks work with MPS to make changes.
Do these organizations now exist, Representative?
Yes. Yep.
They do.
Yep. Very successfully.
Are they nonprofit or for-profit?
Not-for-profit.
Non-for-profit.
And what's cool about that, they exist and they have metrics we could look at and say, yes, you're actually executing, you're getting things done. And so that's what I want to support and work alongside Dr. Darian Driver and her dedication to make this school district better.